Hello guys, welcome to First Step Future India. Today the class is all about Modern India History class 3. In last class we ended with Marathas, right? And this class it's all about Europeans. Why Europeans came into India? Why didn't they come before? So what was the scenario in Europe during this time? This is what we're going to see today. That starts with politics in Europe. During 13th and 14th century, Europe was totally in unrest situation. The unrest situation in the sense there was a lot of war happening. It is called Dark Ages. The war is all between the Christians, scientists, as well as the war between Islams also. The war between Islams and Christians was not visible, but still Islams were always like the between Christians and Islams there was always war for dominance. The religious dominance was there. So Europeans was facing a difficult time, to say that. So what are the reasons for this wars? The first one was conservation of Catholic Church. Second one, the second was one all about association to scientific studies. For example, Catholics, which means church, they want their religions to be dominant. People have to follow the Christianity without asking any questions. But the scientific studies, when the people started to think, they started to ask question about Christianity. Why we have to do everything unquestioned? The changes in their attitude led to the innovative thinking, which means scientific studies started. So this is the major reason between the fight between the Catholic and the scientist. And why this war was so important, why it was affecting people, it is all because the administrative positions was acquired by bishops and cardinals. They got the power, so they were waging war against the scientists. They were not allowed to make any scientific studies. So that led to the war. This social unrest led to the backwardness of people. The economic status, the cultural status, the political status, everything was lost. The people was pushed to the very poverty condition and they have no normal life in Europe. So, Europeans started searching for other territories to plunder money, to get money for their living, for the improvement of their homeland. So, this is the reason why Europeans started looking for another territories. Till now, they didn't search for another territories. From this point only, they started searching for other territories to plunder money. Before getting into how Europeans got into Asia, we have to study about Byzantine Empire and Ottoman Empire. This Byzantine Empire is basically a Christian based empire. They call themselves as Crusaders, which means group of states, they stick together, they follow Christianity, they follow same ideology. They worked as a unit against Islams and they followed the same views. So that made them more powerful, and there was always a political dominance between Islam and Christians. There was no war in visible way, which means to outer world there was no war between Islam and Christians here, but there was always a political dominance between Christians and Islams that they wanted to dominate over each other. This Byzantine Empire was in Turkey, in present-day Greece and Macedonia. Whereas in this Ottoman Empire, this Ottoman Empire took the place of Byzantine Empire. The place wherever Byzantine Empire was had control, now Ottoman Empire succeeded over the Byzantine and took over their territories. This Ottoman Empire is all about Islamic rulers. They were so strong. They were so unit. So they controlled this Constantinople. This Constantinople plays very vital role here. This is the place where this Byzantine Empire also had a control. But why this place alone was having more impact is like where but why this Constantinople had more important between this empire is this is the connecting route between Europe and Asia. Constantinople is the only connecting route between Europe and Asia. So Europeans were not allowed to get into Asia because of this Ottoman Empire. This Arab traders were already came into Asia, got the products, goods, and they were selling to the other part and their own part and getting very good amount of economics. So they don't want Europeans to get into the Asia, so they blocked this Constantinople route completely by imposing high duties, which means when Europeans want to get into Asia, they have to get the Ottoman Empire permissions with high amount of duties. This made even they are in very economical crisis condition, so how can they come into Asia by paying high amount of duties? So obviously the gate is closed for Europeans. This choked Europeans. They tend to find another route through sea, so they searched for sea route. Now let us see what are the positives, what are the strength of Europe's. This Europeans were following capitalist model of economy, which means the government will not interfere in trade of in the company in the country. So they have their own rules, they have their own control, they can make decisions easily without concerning the government. And secondly, this Europeans had another thing also, like they purchase and they manufacture dye with very low amount of money and they sell it to another countries with very large amount of profit. Next, breaking orthodoxy thinking. When they break the orthodoxy thinking, that led to the path to innovative thinking. Their scientific temper have got improved. So that was another strength behind this Europeans, which means once the path is made in religion, everyone was following those paths. So they were not questioning their path, why they are following this, why this is happening. They didn't question anything. So the innovative thinking was missing. But when Europeans started thinking innovatively, they get different ideas, different routes, different approach. So that was another positive thinking for Europeans. Next, shipbuilding experts. They were big shipbuilding experts, especially Portuguese. They loaded their ships along with cannons. They designed in such a way like a warship. During that time, this is the first type of ship the other people see, which means Portuguese are the one who designed the ship with cannons. So it is a unique way, and this is how they dominated others, especially other Europeans too. Spreading Christianity motives. Like spreading Christianity gave more force to them, more motivation to them. They think themselves as a very cultured persons because they are Christians. The non-Christians are uncultured according to them. So it is a responsibility for them to spread culture by spreading Christianity all over the world. So it was another motivation thing they had. So 1487, this Bartolomeo Dias, he is the first person who go around Africa to reach east coast of Africa, but he didn't find the route to Asia. He didn't found the route for India. But in 1498, Vasco da Gama found Asia, the route to Asia, which is a Malabar coast. Here in Malabar coast, he was very warm welcomed by the Calicut Zamorians. Present day Kozhikode, these people, they encouraged him to trade, which means like paper, these are all very new things to them. Vasco da Gama, he took all the goods from there, and it was having very very good amount of demand in all over the globe. So he started trading with this Asians, which means India, especially Malabar coast. But this made insecurity feeling to Arab traders, which means Ottoman traders. They were trading through the land. Now they had the monopoly till the Portuguese get into the land. But now Arab has lost their monopoly. This created insecurity to them. As well as British also got the route. Vasco da Gama is a Portuguese, whereas British is another European. British got the route as the Vasco da Gama came. So British came to the Asia for trading purpose. Here what happens is British got the goods from Asia, which means India, and British sold it for very high profit, and that high profit were shared with the Calicut Zamorians, which means they got very high profit when they sold goods to British. So obviously this Zamorians were more interested to sell their goods to British rather than Portuguese or Arabs. So now both Arabs and Portuguese got irritated, especially Portuguese become very angry, aggressive and greedy with the local Indian rulers, and they threatened Indian rulers not to trade with British. But Indian rulers were opposing this, and they said they are very neutral to everyone, and since we get very good amount of profit, we trading with British. So that led to the Blue Water Policy. What is this Blue Water Policy? Basically, Portuguese were fighting with Indians as well as British to get the dominance, monopoly over trade in Malabar Coast, which means India. So that is this Blue Water Policy. The first person who came into India was Vasco da Gama. Next, following him, Francisco de Almeida, and third one is Alfonso de Albuquerque and Nino da Cunha. These are the persons, Portuguese, who came into India. But when the Indians were opposed by this Portuguese for trading with British, Vasco da Gama and Francisco de Almeida both waged war against Malabar, which means they were attacking those people, were destroying their properties with the ships, with cannons, all the explosives, everything. So by this way they got dominance over the place, and they become the masters of ocean. So this is the main aim of Francis de Almeida also, and his ultimate aim is like making Portuguese as a master of oceans. Here they got the dominance over the Indian coast, and they become the monopoly of trade here. But till now, Francis de Almeida, they don't want any territory or land property in India because they just wanted trade monopoly. But after him, who is the follower, Alfonso de Albuquerque, he wanted territory in India. He believes that having territory and land is the only strategic way to hold more profit and hold more control over India. So he is the one who bought permit system, and he encouraged marriage between Portuguese men and local Indian girls, and he is the one who acquired Goa, and he is the one first abolished sati in 1510 in India. In 1510, the sati was totally abolished in Goa. So this is the first instance. After him, Nino da Cunha was the next follower in Portuguese. Okay, so this is the video is all about today. In next video, we will see what are the main features of Portuguese, what we have to learn from them, and how British got dominance over Portuguese. We'll see all this in subsequent videos. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe, and study well. Thank you.